Hi, welcome to another episode of the Tech-Knowledgy Show. I'm Daniel, and I'm going to show you how to build a computer from scratch here today. This is some of the parts that you're going to need here. You need a case, basically, that's the shell that holds all the parts inside here. This is the power supply. This is the back end that comes, that shows on the outside of the case that you would have here. You'll have a fan somewhere on it, and then all the cables that connect, that give you the power to everything. You're also going to need a hard drive that will come in this. And you can get them various sizes and types, so you got to make sure you get the right one that is for your motherboard that it can take. Of course, you got the motherboard itself, which I still have in the shrink wrap here. They come in all kinds of colors, shapes, sizes. Maybe not the shapes, but the sizes of them will make a difference. Now, the size, this is a mini case, and this is a mini board. Now, if you're going to want to use a small case, you need to make sure that you get a small board like this that can fit in the case. Otherwise, it's going to be too big for the case, and it simply won't fit. So, you got to make sure you got the right size for that. Some of the other things, you're going to need a processor, which will come in your box. These are all buying them individually yourself. And it's got the fan on it, which is what most people see from the top, but they don't see the other more critical piece to the system, which is the actual processor itself. So you're going to need that. We'll get to all these in more detail in a bit. And then the memory will also come in a small case there. You'll have some kind of a CD, DVD drive, and of course, last but not least, you'll need some kind of software to install on it for the operating system. So we're going to get to start building this. So the first thing we're going to want to do is get the motherboard inside the system, and you want to position it where all these connectors are going to be on the outside here. So when this goes in, it'll be showing on the outside. Now, of course, that doesn't look right still because we're missing a part. So you can kind of look at it with the motherboard so you can see where it goes. So obviously it wouldn't fit the other way. It goes in from the inside. And if you can get it close up enough on it, you can see it just snaps in. So that's in place. Next, the motherboard goes in. Now, if you can see inside inside the case here, you want to bring it down and slide it in. Now, there's spots where the screws will go here, and some of them require extra pieces where the screw would screw into, and they're already in here. Otherwise, it comes with a bag of stuff where you can put that in. So we want to put the board down, and we're basically sliding it in. Maybe if I turn this around a little better, we can get a better shot of it here. So the board is back here. We're going to slide it in, but you can see there's a couple of lips here, and these things have to sit on top. So I've seen people build some computers, and they totally ignored those lips and pushed it right out, and it got in the way, you see, of these things here. So where the network connection goes into, that lip was covering it completely, so they couldn't plug the cable in. It was completely in the way. So it was either unscrew everything, take it all apart to fix that, or just snap the end off. It's better to do it properly so you have that contact on there, but it slides in. And now we've got the places here where we can screw. We can see the holes in behind. So I'm going to get the screws and screw this. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws in this one, and that's typical. Some of them you may find 4, you could have up to 8 screws depending on the size of the board again. So that's all screwed in place. We flip it around. Now you can see the end. So that's what it normally looks like when you have a finished computer, except for the power supply, which is the next thing we're going to put in. Technically, it doesn't matter what order you do this in, but the motherboard, you want to have it first before you put anything else down. So with this, we want to make sure this side is the outside. You got the cables, obviously, are going to be inside the case. So I'll just hang those over the edge, drop this down carefully. No, actually drop it, of course. And then that's going to sit there, and we screw it in. Okay, that's in. One thing I like to do in the beginning of this is to put down the main power source to the motherboard, and it also helps to ground it a bit. Now, you can see these come split. Now, this actually says this is a 24 pin. Now, all the new power supplies come with an extra 4 pins. So you can see this way that there's 4 pins on that. This has got 24. So the new ones here have the extra 4 pins to give it that extra bit of power because the motherboards are more powerful now. So we want to snap that down in here, and this white piece here is where that goes. So we're going to put this in there. Make sure it's down good. You don't want to press overly hard where the motherboard is going to really take damage, but you want to push down firm. These other cables that we have from the case, this runs to the front for a different adapter, so we're going to plug these in at the end, and I'll go through what those are after. Now, the processor, before we put that in, there's a seal here, so we want to pop this off, and you can probably see says that it's for the motherboard. Now you want to hold on to that because if there's a problem with the motherboard, you need to put that back on before you return it, so you want to keep that with you. What I like to do is the box that the motherboard came in, you can keep the manual, the extra cables, this type of stuff, all the warranty stuff. It's a great way to keep all your information about the computer all together, all in one place. So it comes in handy. So I keep that box. As far as all the other boxes, we just toss them when you're done with that. Alright, so what we're going to do is put the processor in, which is this tiny little piece. Okay. Most people don't even know. Now, again, with that piece, I just threw it there, but that's, we're going to hold on to that because, again, if there's a